Hi everybody, my name is Marissa and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, we are going to define random circumstances as well as probability. A random circumstance is a situation that has an unpredictable outcome. Sometimes the outcome is not determined until we observe it, and sometimes it is already determined, but we just do not know the outcome yet. For example, if we pick a card from a deck of 52 cards, we have no idea what card we are going to choose. However, if we take a test to see whether or not we have a disease, the outcome is already determined. We already have the disease or do not have the disease. We just do not know the outcomes until we get our test results. All random circumstances have probabilities associated with them. Sometimes, the probabilities for the outcomes of random circumstances are dependent on other potential outcomes, and sometimes they are not. For example, if we flip a coin 10 times, the probability of getting heads or tails is not dependent on any of the previous flips. This means that if we got tails for the first two flips, this does not tell us anything about what we are going to get on our third flip. Events where one outcome of a random circumstance does not affect another outcome are known as independent events. However, let's say that we want to know the probability of selecting a four of hearts when we choose two cards from a deck of 52 cards. This is known as a dependent event because on our first pick, our probability of getting a four of hearts is 1 in 52. But if we do not select the four of hearts on our first try, our probability of selecting a four of hearts is now 1 in 51, since a card was taken out of the deck already. However, if we would have selected the 4 of hearts the first time, the probability of selecting it on the second pick would be 0, because there was only one 4 of hearts in the deck. There are some important rules that we must follow when computing the probabilities of random circumstances. First, a probability is always a value between 0 and 1, and expressed as either a decimal or a fraction. When multiplied by 100, probabilities can turn into percentages. For example, a random circumstance with a probability of 0.53 has a 53% chance of happening. When we think about probabilities as percentages, it makes sense that they can never be below 0 or above 1, because nothing can have a negative chance or over 100% chance of occurring. When considering all potential outcomes of a random circumstance, adding the probabilities of each outcome must equal 1. For example, when rolling a die, we have 6 potential outcomes: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Each outcome has a 1 out of 6 chance of happening, and when we add 1 over 6 6 times, this gives us a probability of 1. Dependent events can be tricky. A question we must ask ourselves when assigning probabilities to random circumstances is, does another outcome in this random circumstance affect another event? If we answered yes, it is a great idea to visualize our probabilities. For example, let's say that we have a bag of 2 red balls, 3 green balls, and 1 yellow ball, and we want to know the probability of selecting the yellow ball if we are given 2 chances to pick a ball. For our first pick, we have 1 yellow ball and a total of 6 balls. Let's say that we pick a green ball on our first pick. We are now down to only 5 balls. So, our new probability for choosing a yellow ball on our second try is 1 out of 5. Now, let's imagine that we select the yellow ball on our first try. The probability of selecting the yellow ball on the second try is now 0. Because of random circumstances, in this event depend on each other, we know this is a dependent event. Let's test out our knowledge on random circumstances and probabilities by doing 2 quick exercises. A pregnant woman visits an ultrasound technician to see if she is having a boy or a girl. Is this random circumstance determined or not yet determined? This random circumstance has already been determined since the sex of the baby existed already. The woman just will not know it until the ultrasound technician tells her. Seth is a basketball player who is practicing his foul shots. He has made 4 shots so far and thinks that because he usually only makes 50% of his shots, He is less likely to make the next one because he already made 4 shots. Is this logic sound? Explain. Seth's logic is not sound. Whether he already made 5 shots or missed 100 shots, it has no bearing on whether or not he will make or miss the next shot. Great job, everyone. Today we learned about random circumstances. We also learned about the basics of probability. Thanks for watching, and please be sure to check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.